Yiwu, in the eyes of many foreigners in China, is the world's capital of small commodities, a city of economic prosperity, and a land of dreams. Businessmen from all over the world choose to do business in Yiwu.
But today, as a foreigner, I come to Yiwu to tell you another great story you've never heard before.
I'm Tom from the UK. I have been working in China for 3 years now, with the last year being spent in Hangzhou, Zhejiang province. I studied contemporary history and international politics as a graduate student in the UK. During this period,
I learned about the Communist Manifesto written by Karl Marx and Frederick Engels.
So when I heard that Taiwanese Chen Wangdao
was the translator of the first officially published
Chinese version
of the Communist Manifesto,
I became very interested in knowing more about the man and his story. It dates back to 1848, when the Communist Manifesto was published in the UK. More than 70 years later, a native of Yiwu, a city in Zhejiang province, finished its complete Chinese translation.
This is Chen Wangdao from Yiwu. It's surprising to think that Yiwu is the place where the complete Chinese version of the Communist Manifesto was translated. Has this part of Yiwu's history presented a fresh image of the city to you? The story behind it is also quite fascinating. Over 100 years ago, Chen Wangdao, a native of Yiwu, was born in this village. Today, I'm going to meet with one of his relatives to find out more about his story.
慢点啊，谢谢。那个，这个房子呢，是1906年造好的，中间这个三间是陈万道的。陈万道家庭在我们当地是算一等一的家庭，经济条件也好，为人处事也好，啊，各个方面都算比较好的。那陈万道准备出国，先后到上海和杭州的那个之江大学补习英语。1915年的二月到日本留学，在日本留学期呢，非常的认真，也非常的努力。
Early in the 20th century, China's industry had just started with a very weak foundation. The impoverished rural areas were even worse. Important urban centers in large cities were under foreign control. This greatly affected the forward-thinking youths of that period and indirectly inspired them to search for better ways to save the country.
At that time, both the English and the Japanese translations of the Communist Manifesto had already spread to China. But who was the best person to translate the Communist Manifesto into Chinese? I'm going to give someone a call to find out. Nihao, Chen 教授.
Tom, 你好. 就是邵律师当时为什么会推荐我父亲来翻译这个《共产宣言》呢？要翻译这本小册子的第一个条件就是要对这个马克思主义呢要比较深的了解，第二个就是要精通德文、日文、英文这三门外语当中一门，第三个条件就是说对这个汉语言这个文学素养要比较高。
Chen Wangdao was surprised and excited by the invitation. He took the English and Japanese versions of the Communist Manifesto back to his hometown and began to translate the manifesto in his old shed in Fengshuitang village, Yiwu.
When Chen Wangdao was translating, an interesting thing happened.
因为他是白天黑夜连着转的，所以说没有几天大概人就瘦了一圈。我祖母弄了点糯米，然后呢包了几个粽子。 再加上一点我们这个家乡盛产的红糖，想给它补补身体。过了一会儿，他想到吃的差不多，去收拾这个碗碟，一看，你这个嘴巴上怎么都是黑乎乎的？啊，怎么回事情啊？我父亲他自己也不知道，实在是思想过于集中，就把这个就是蘸着粽子蘸着沫子，把它吃下去，自己还一点感觉都没有，啊，还说好甜好甜。
And that's the origin of the saying, the taste of truth is so sweet.
Come on， 这就是我们讲的柴房，这是陈王道吗？
哎，
对，这就是陈王道先生，当时100年前翻译《共产党宣言》的场景。当时的条件很艰苦的，白天就当办公桌，晚上呢这些东西拿走，用那个被子一铺，他就当床了。想到一个词，或者一句话，他咕隆咚站起来，他就马上就把它写下来。经过2个多月时间，
两个多月时间，他都在这里吗？
啊，对，都在这里。那么1920年2月回家，到1920年4月的下旬，基本完成了这个翻译。然后他带了译稿到上海。1920年8月，中文版《共产党宣言》第一版出版。
One year after Chen Wangdao's translation was published, the Communist Party of China was founded.
In October 1936, Mao Zedong told the American journalist Edgar Snow, "There are three books deeply engraved within my heart that established my belief in Marxism." One of these books was the complete Chinese version of the Communist Manifesto.
As a foreigner, I can't help but marvel at this seemingly ordinary but significant story from Zhejiang. After learning about this, I feel like I'm getting a deeper understanding of China.